So are you now ready?
Swaroom? I mean, you?
अभी से जर्मन मत बोल.
काय ओटी भरतात ना, कसं हात पोडे करतो तसं केलेले
मी.
ओके, रेडी.
Hi, this is Amrita Sukumar, and I'm bringing to you this podcast called Unsettling. Look around you. Everyone is trying to create their own story. Make a tiny change in someone's life by just following their passion, and in turn, inspiring the others to follow suit. This podcast brings to you stories of people who have defied the definition of settled set by the society and have created their own. They have found happiness in their version of settled.
What is yours? Language helps us communicate with each other, and we learned all the languages that we had to learn when we were kids. So whenever we learn a new language, this has happened with me. People come and ask me to teach them a few phrases in Malayalam, and usually they say, hey, Malayalam sikha na, aur ek do gaali bhi sikha dena. So any non-Malayali who is not in south of India knows only three things: ninde perenda, tendi, and patti. But then there are some people who voluntarily go and learn a new language. I will be talking to one such person today, and she is here with me. Hi, Anaya.
Hey, Amrita. It's so good to listen my entire name for the first time.
Oh, I know. I keep calling you Anu. And I actually had to write this down to make sure that I don't mispronounce your name.
Okay, Amrita.
So, Anu, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
So, hi guys, this is Anaya, and I'm working with an MNC in Bangalore, and I'm working as a German language specialist.
German language specialist. So, when did you decide to learn a new language? And why German? Like, why not French or Italian or maybe Malayalam? Why did you learn German?
For the first time, I feel that, okay, learning a foreign language will be better than learning an Indian language. Career-wise, okay, oh. I had started, German as my second language when I was doing my, when I was in a junior college. So that is where I, developed the interest for a foreign language. So I initially started, I had taken this as a subject just because, haan, theek hai, scoring hai, 12th mein, it'll help me get good marks. But by the end of the second year of junior college, I fell in love with the subject, and I knew then that I'll be making a career in this language.
Oh, great. And which institute did you study German from?
It's a very renowned institute. I'm sure most of them will be knowing. It's called Max Müller Bhavan, and it has got its branches all over India and even outside. But in India, I can specifically say that it has got its branches in Pune, Mumbai, Chennai, Bangalore. So MMB, as it's known, Max Müller Bhavan. So I've done my courses from there, and I am a B2 certified to date.
Oh, so what are the certificates that are there in German?
Actually, there are like 6 certificates that you go through if you have to learn the entire language. It's A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2. So, and it has got a little bifurcations as well. But it'll be better if you directly go to the site wherein the detailed information is given. And I'm sure anybody who wants to learn the language, the site is very useful. And you'll come to know the gist of how the language will be taught to you. How much time is it going to take, and the fee structure and everything.
Oh.
So, yeah.
Okay. So then are there any interesting activities that help you learn the language better?
Oh, this is the best part about Max Müller Bhavan, that knowing that all of us did not have a background of the language. So I feel it's very easy that when you're in a school or college and you're taking it as a subject, probably it's very easy for you to learn a language. But when you're doing it willingly at a age that, sare basic language to aate, abhi nayi language seekhna, you have to forget the basics of the other language and then learn a new language. That is the difficult part. So I still remember when we were in our first class, that is A1, and you will not believe, we were not taught ABCD in the first class. We were taught the greetings, like good morning kaise bolte hai, good night kaise bolte hai. Because this is how, this is what is useful in your, life that you have to know to interact. Yes, we were obviously taught ABCD in our days to come, but we did not start with learning ABCD.
Okay,
and so the best part is that, whatever we were learning, so we were taught as if, it's a game and we need to play, and this is how we kept learning a language. Because if you don't fall in love with the language initially, then probably it's very mechanical ki haan bas pass hona hai, certificate lena hai, isliye padho. But this is not what happens in MMB. So just one little, that strikes my mind right now, that we had learned numbers. Generally, 1, 2, 3, 4, we learn, and it was very mechanical. Theek hai, chalo, we are learning ki, okay, 1 ko kya bolte, 2 ko kya bolte. We never thought that we could play with the numbers the next day, and which will all actually be a revision ki, do we remember what 12 is called in German, what 21 is called in German, and so on. So on. We played housey the next, yeah, because we were so engrossed in, what is, ma'am said 21 in German, like it is 21. So she said 21. So we were calculating, okay, 21 in English is, okay, 21. Then do we have it on our paper? Calculating all these things was very funny because we played housey and it was not so complicated then. But then later we realized that this was one way that we knew the numbers in a better way. Now I cannot forget any numbers till date.
Oh, that is great. That is an interesting activity. So when we learn a new language, we usually think in a mother tongue and then literally translate it. Yeah. I had a physics teacher. I mean, even you had her. You remember, she used to think in Marathi and then literally translate it.
Yeah.
I remember one phrase really clearly. She used to say, morning, don't rotate my head. It's a literal translation from Marathi's, Sakai,
dokkano ko firo.
Exactly. Did this ever happen when you were learning a new language?
This is one thing which we all, fall prey for, that, whenever we are learning a new language, we tend to think in our comfortable language, like English or Marathi in my case, and then we try to translate it. So technically, probably it will be right. Okay, whatever I'm translating, that is right. But the think in a way that, I have translated, suppose, 5 lines from English to German, but then it doesn't make sense because there is no connectivity. So that is where thinking in German and then writing it in German makes sense. Mm-hmm. If you're translating it, wo flow nahi rehta. If you're writing something, wo flow nahi rehta. Because you're literally word-to-word translation kar rahe ho, that doesn't make sense. So if you're, that is what the institute teaches us, that, you start thinking in German. So that whatever you write, you're writing an essay, you're writing a poem, it doesn't feel like you have translated it.
Okay. But were there any funny incidents that you would like to share which happened?
Oh yeah, when we were in A1, we were just so naive that, literally chote-chote cheeze hum log translate karte the. Ki yaar, English mein aisa hai, toh ke German mein bhi aisa hoga. But then that is not literal. Koi incident abhi dimag mein nahi aa raha, but okay. I know that we have done a lot of such mistakes.
Okay. So then, now you know German and most of your friends who were in MMB know German. How does it feel to have a secret language, at least in our country, that only a few of you know?
Oh, that's a power. Yeah. Actually, it's something that just popped in my mind. I used to travel with a friend of mine from my place to the class, and we used to travel by bus. Uh-huh. So it was a 1 hour long journey every day. So, we both were in the German class, we were learning German. So the only way wherein, we could stay in touch with the language even after the classes, when we used to converse with each other in German in the bus also. So that is one way, we used to, kya bol sakte, we used to not think ki are yaar you know compulsory bolna pad raha hai or something like that. We used to enjoy it, isliye hum bolte the. And you know the funniest part, हम लोग बस में ना आजू बाजू के लोगों की मिमिक्री करते थे, उन पे कमेंट्स मारते थे, एंड दे यूज्ड टू नॉट इवन अंडरस्टैंड बिकॉज़ वी वर टॉकिंग इन जर्मन, एंड दैट वाज़ द बेस्ट पार्ट. मतलब वी आर कमेंटिंग ऑन देम, आई नो दैट्स बैड बट ओके, यू नो दैट इज सम एडवांटेज ऑफ नोइंग अ लैंग्वेज व्हिच नॉट मेनी पीपल नो अराउंड.
सो आई शुड मेक श्योर दैट आई डोंट मेक यू एंग्री, अदरवाइज यू नो जर्मन एंड आई वोंट नो व्हाट इज गोइंग ऑन.
नहीं वो दैट इज द बेस्ट थिंग ना, हम लोग को तो गालियां भी पेपर दे के सिखाई थी. मतलब आई वी हैड गॉट अ शीट वेयर इन यू नो ऑल द बैड वर्ड्स स्वेयर वर्ड्स वर रिटन.
अच्छा यू वर ट्रेन्ड बिफोर हैंड, ये है
या
इन केस यू डोंट स्पीक द लैंग्वेज वेल दिस इज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू कम फ्रॉम द क्लाइंट.
एग्जैक्टली
ओके. सो आई वांट टू नो व्हाट इज द प्रोफेशनल स्कोप ऑफ लर्निंग अ फॉरेन लैंग्वेज एस्पेशियली जर्मन.
I was lucky enough that I got a job as a translator immediately after my courses, but there are also job opportunities like you can be a corporate trainer for a foreign language. There are a lot of companies out there who you know look out for people who can train their employees in any of the foreign languages. So that is one really great career path. You can be a interpreter. It's not exactly like translator. Translator is what you do on paper. Interpreter is more of a
conversation
thing. That's right. Uh-huh. So these are the few things which wherein you can focus on. And any these days, there are a lot of German institutes around. You know, a lot of foreign language institutes wherein you know you get highly paid to be a teacher.
Okay.
So that is also one great career path, and if you want to open your own classes,
that
कौन रोक रहा है यार?
I know, I know. ये अच्छा है. Like I can learn a new language and maybe do something different about it. So, do you have any other goals that you are planning to follow? And do you have any other goals, or this is something you're content with?
See, I am not a person who will settle down for, you know, okay, now I have achieved, okay, I wanted to be a translator, I am a translator, that's it.
Okay.
Probably, I will have, you know, translation going on, you know, side by side, but I am always a person who wants to learn something new and probably, you know, incorporate it as a career option as well.
Okay.
I am not kidding. And I know, maine kabhi ye bola nahi hai, lekin I always wanted to learn photography.
Okay.
And probably, going forward, you know, आजकल यार ये फोटोग्राफी का इतना फैड बन चुका है, यू नो तुम शादी के पे.
I think you should stay tuned to our podcast. There is one photographer as well who
has
a bit of tips, so maybe that will help you.
of course, because this field now like photography, अभी मैं according to me, तुम शादी कर रहे हो फोटो खींच लो, बच्चा पैदा कर रहे हो फोटो खींच लो, यू नो फॉर एवरीथिंग देयर इज यू नो there is an option ki yaar we can have a photo shoot before that.
Correct.
So considering all this and my love for photography, this is what something I would, you know, give it a shot at least give it a shot at.
Okay, that's really interesting. So did you do anything prior to being a German tester professionally?
Yeah. Okay, so I was working as a software tester in a multinational company in Pune. So yeah, I was soon after my graduation, I would say that you know, there were walk-ins, we went and I got hired, and that is where I started my career in a software, you know, in in the corporate field. So that is where I started my career, but I always knew ki yaar ye this is not my cup of tea, mujhe ye nahi karna. At the end of the day, where I want to have my career in is ki German. Ye mujhe pata tha. So but just because we were just out of college, job lag gayi thi, maine bola chalo let's do it. So it went on, wo let's do it ke chakkar mein it went on for 3 years.
Okay.
And after that I just was like, nahi yaar, if I waste time like this, probably I'll not be satisfied at the end of it.
Yeah.
So that's when I left my job. I learned this language for a year, and then I got a job here now.
Okay.
As a translator.
So you said you took a 1 year break. How did it feel when the monthly salary stopped coming? Did you, start doubting yourself or did you start listening to other people? Kyun job chhodi, jao jao, wapas jao, job karo.
No, there were a lot of people who had criticized me before I was, I was unemployed. Like, maine quit kar diya tha, but I was still, wo notice period mein thi. So everybody think about it again. You still have time. You never think about it ke chakkar mein 3 saal nikal gaye aur kitna think karu. So, but yeah, as you said ki, the one thing that made sure ki, this decision of mine was backed up with just one thing, ki I know I'll not be earning for the, for some time now, mm-hmm. but I never wanted to be dependent again. Mm-hmm. I was independent, and that is why I quit the job when I knew that I could support myself with the courses I'm going through.
Okay.
So, because...
Saving for yourself so that you could go and do the courses.
Yes, yes, okay. Yes. So that is one thing which, believe that one should have that, okay, if you were independent and you are dependent now, it's like, nahi yaar, wo, for me, it was, no, I just can't go get back to being dependent again. Yes. So, isiliye, I had that savings done so and only then.
So you had pre-planned it and then...
Yes, yes, yes. Of course, taking such a risk needs planning.
Correct. So the entire podcast is about unsettling. What is your definition of settling?
Okay. Settling, probably, I would say that someone who doesn't have that urge of learning something new professionally, probably that person is settled. Like, they're happy in what they're doing, or they don't have that urge of learning something new.
Mm-hmm.
Then I think that person is, settled and, they're happy with their life, how it's going. They don't want any other changes in their life, which is also okay. I'm not complaining about that, but that is settled, is according to me.
Okay. And do you have any message for our fellow unsettlers?
Guys, it is okay to be an unsettler. It is completely fine. Just the thing, you have to make sure that you're happy in what you're doing. You should, keep learning. Keep being a better person every day. Professionally, personally. And it's completely fine. And somewhere down the line, just make sure that even though you're not settled or you're an unsettler, somewhere you should know that you have to be independent, and if you are independent financially and in every aspect, probably it's no harm in being an unsettler. Perfectly fine.
Any message maybe that you could give your 16-year-old self?
Something which I would say to a 16-year-old self of mine, I would say that probably I should have gone with my gut feeling soon when I realized that language was my career option, and not fall prey to what society will think, and this is not a good career option, and you should at least ye kar le, 12th pe acche marks liya, fir dekhte hain. Achha, theek hai, abhi 12th mein acche marks aage, BSc kar le, fir dekhte hain. So
this, I shouldn't have this plan B thing that we are sold all the time.
Exactly.
I think that is something that we have to get out of, and we have to pick out what are our strengths.
Yes, and always go for plan A, and if you have a plan B, plan A is not actually your plan A.
But that depends on certain situations. I think German has a lot of scope, and it is important that people know what the scope is so that they are not pressurized by the society to choose something else which they are not interested in. So foreign language has a lot of scope. That's what Anu is trying to tell us. And if you are really interested and you want to pursue it, it's very important that you start early and just learn it for the fun of it. Maybe you meet a foreigner and you're able to converse with them in this language.
Exactly. You never know. You end up getting a date with a German guy, and Germans are hot, by the way.
Thank you for the info, and now I'm going to join the German class as soon as possible. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you for talking about unsettling, and thank you for talking about German. I'm sure there are a lot of people out there who want to learn a foreign language and not Malayalam. I'm really mad at you. Please come and learn it from me. I'm sure they will learn a lot of things after listening to this podcast. Thank you so much for your time.
Oh, my pleasure. My pleasure.
If you have any queries, you can always comment or send me a DM on my Insta page or send me a mail and I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. I hope you enjoyed today's podcast. Stay tuned.